Antidote comes from the ancient Greek word antidoton, which means given as a remedy. Antidote is a noun that can be defined as something that works against an unwanted condition to make it better. This can range widely from antidotes to snake bites or other poisons like poison ivy, or antidotes to anxiety, loneliness, and in the case of this video, an antidote to addiction. And at this point, you may be thinking of a physical antidote, such as a medication, natural remedy, medical treatment, or a combination of natural remedies for having antidotal benefits for healing an addiction. However, in this particular video, what you'll be learning about is a novel addiction antidote that you may have overlooked or not thought about previously. This is a powerful antidote for addiction that many have used, which has had miraculous results for countless individuals since the beginning of the addiction phenomenon in human civilization. It has powers that cannot be measured by modern science, and many think of this antidote as lame, weak, dogmatic, or even laughable. The antidote in question we're referring to is the love and light of the one infinite creator. This one infinite creator has been called many names: God, Allah, Jesus Christ, the universe, the cosmic mind, the universal mind, and many others. Many people are turned off by the notion of an infinite intelligence that created the universe. And that is why this video title is An Antidote to Addiction, and not The Antidote to Addiction. For people that are not interested or even open-minded about the learned teaching of a so-called intelligent infinity of love, light, light, love, they can find numerous other antidotes to addiction, as we assure you there are many. However, for even the most agnostic or even atheist, it could be beneficial to realize that the mind is like a parachute. It only works if it's open. So, how can this metaphysical energy act as an antidote to addiction? As stated previously, there is no way to scientifically verify this. Yet seemingly miraculous things happen when individuals surrender their ego and will and life to infinite intelligence. This is done through faith. A leap of faith is taken without any proof that things will get better, and a surrendering of the ego takes place. In 12-step fellowships, the third step is surrender the will of the ego and a humble requesting for God or some type of higher power to work its infinite powers to guide and direct the person instead. And many look upon this as weak or dogmatic, but many report instant or fast-acting benefits through this step. For Christians and other people of religious faith, this is often an easy thing to do, to surrender their ego and ask for their creator to help out. For analytical, scientifically oriented, evolution-based, and skeptical-minded individuals, this seems like nonsense. And thus, this wouldn't be a great antidote to addiction for them unless they are open-minded enough to try it out for a while and see what happens as a kind of experiment. For people that are religious, oftentimes diving deep into their religion and asking their creator to help them heal the addiction can often produce extraordinary results in their personal life. For people that are not religious but spiritual, this can often work equally well. It may seem silly, weak, or like a total waste of time for many, but if they've been unable to heal from addiction on their own, then perhaps trying something new like this couldn't hurt. Perhaps nothing will happen. But it's doubtful an addiction would worsen from asking the divine guidance from a metaphysical perspective. Each person is unique, and each person is on their own journey and path, and thus each person gets to exercise their own free will in the way they wish. While there are many antidotes to addiction, for certain individuals, years and years go by, and despite their best efforts and motivation, they remain addicted, or they accomplish temporary sobriety, recovery, or abstinence only to relapse back into the addictive cycle. For many, religions have soured the concept of God and left a foul taste in their mouth. And for many, spiritual concepts have seemed airy-fairy and thus have also left a foul taste in their mouth. But for the people that are truly desperate to heal from addiction, perhaps their biases might be best laid down for an experimental test on the self. Being stuck in an addiction can feel like being a rat in a cage, running on a rat wheel, faster and faster, yet going nowhere and staying stuck in the cage. It's questionable whether or not accessing divine intelligence could even work, but again, it could be that the potential benefits are life-changing, while the potential negative consequences seem nil to none. And of course, addictions affect the brain and mind, so these elements should always be addressed as well, regardless of the chosen antidote protocol for attempting to heal an addiction and restore health. And yet, the spiritual antidote to addiction seems to be on the decline, and it's interesting that rates of addiction are on the incline in near proportion to the amount of spiritual decline. Each person gets to exercise their own free will in this matter, and no person is wrong for choosing to believe and utilize what they believe and utilize. Each person gets to choose whether they follow the path of their mind heart, intuition, or even their creator. And each person learns lessons from the struggle and can always choose to either suffer more by their spin on their predicament or end suffering by the meaning they associate with their predicament. Finally, each person has untapped potential and untapped resources within their own self and outside of their own self. And these untapped resources often hold the key to help them unlock the cage they have become trapped in.